Today we're making my version of red braised pork belly. And let me tell you something, this stuff is insane. No time to waste, my friends. Now let's go! Get some boiling water ready, and we'll drop our large slabs of pork belly in. This will help to remove some impurities, if you ask the French, but also make the pork a lot easier to work with on the next step, meaning slicing, as well as holding a nice shape through the cooking process. And if there's anybody in the comments that knows more about Chinese cooking than me, because I'm no expert, please chime in and let us know what's up. Just about 2 minutes, I'm gonna get those out. And I know a lot of people save this water and cook with it, but for me, this is almost like purging, if you know that cooking terminology, meaning if you get a bunch of chicken bones or something, you might bring them all to a boil in water, discard that whole first batch of water, refill, and then make your stock or sauce or whatever, and it'll just be a whole lot cleaner. I'm getting rid of this. That's just my own cooking intuition. You know, don't hate me for it. Let your pork cool down for about 5 minutes. Right, now the pork, I'm just gonna slice into nice squares. And that blanching does make this really easy. Nice piece like that. As you can see, the pork is totally raw still. Ooh, this is satisfying, I'll tell you what. Pork belly is just the perfect meat. I don't know what else to say. And one thing I would like you to do here is sacrifice the fat from two of these little pieces of pork belly. Save these, we're gonna use them in a second. Medium heat pan, and we'll just add those two little pieces of pork fat. Now, as all that pork fat begins to release, we're gonna add in some dried chili and Szechuan peppercorn, and we're just gonna toast this all off over here in the fat for a minute. Smell is haunting. So just about 30 seconds, then add your water, rice wine. I'm just using dark soy sauce. Most recipes call for a combination of light and dark, but I don't want anyone to be excluded. If you have soy sauce, you can make it, okay? By the way, this soy sauce from Taiwan, Wanjiashan, I don't know if I'm saying it right, incredible. I just got this on Amazon. If I can find a link, I'll put it. Some light brown sugar going in. Cinnamon and star anise, and some slivers of ginger. Give it a good mix. Now, all our beautiful cubed pork belly going back in. Now keep that heat low. Low and slow with just a cracked lid like this. Heat is just a touch over low, just a light simmer. Okay, pork's been going for an hour at this point. I'm gonna add in a bunch of fresh garlic. Oh my gosh, it smells insane. Cracked lid back on, continue cooking. Okay, about 2.5 hours on that pork belly. Now I'll just turn the heat off and let that pork belly relax in the liquid it cooked in. And then we'll go to the next step. That's a big mistake, by the way. Pro tip, some alpha for you right here. Don't pull your braised meat out of the braising liquid right away. Always let it cool down in the liquid. I'll give this about an hour and then I'll go on to the next step. Once that's cooled down, we'll begin removing the pork belly. Put that in something. Look at the jiggle. Man, I'm all about the meat jiggle. Isn't that satisfying? I'll keep going. I can do more. Now, I'll strain out my sauce. Time to reduce. Alternatively, you could mix cornstarch with water and just slowly stream it in little by little and whisk it in, and that will thicken the sauce. That's the quick version if you don't want to wait, but there's so much beautiful gelatin in that pork belly that's now in the sauce. And so as this reduces, it will get thick naturally on its own. If you have the time, that is preferred. Another thing to note is I got rid of about 80% of that fat that was on top. Some of that fat on purpose, because fat carries a lot of flavor. And in this case, the flavor from all those wonderful spices we put in. So we don't want a greasy sauce, but at the same time, we always want to leave a little bit of fat in our sauces. That's just a good general tip you can take to the bank. And by bank, I mean MetaMask. One more great tip for sauces, take a brush and some hot water, and I'm sure you've noticed whenever you're reducing something, all this mess that appears on the sides, not only does that make cleanup really hard, but that's all essentially flavor that should be in the sauce, not on the sides of the pot. So take your brush, hot water, and you just brush along the sides. Like so, really easy to do, and you just want to do that every 10 minutes or so. That's a good one, my friends. Okay, now our sauce has reduced by about half, turning the heat all the way down, and I'm just gonna start dropping my pork belly back in, making sure I don't get any of those spices. Although the garlic, I'm happy to put in there. Now this pork belly is gonna slowly warm up in this sauce, and then it's ready to go. Gonna be so unbelievably tender. Oh, the time has finally arrived. Unbelievable. Until next time, my friends. You know, I love you. And I'm out.